It's disgusting.
Thanks for coming away.
The Victorians, as we know, were obsessed with death. And this obsession shaped their attitude to nature.
By preserving nature through the art of taxidermy, they were able to create the illusion of immortality, to convince themselves they could ward off change.
Are you all right there, Philip?
It's the damn thing that's always sticking.
Your room is down here, isn't it? Shall we have a look? I'll do you a deal. You get dressed, and I'll make you a couple.
But what really captured the Victorian imagination was the grotesque, the malformed being, the freak of nature. Scientists were fascinated by teratology, literally, the study of monsters.
Talika, sorry to chase, but we're just doing the lighting, so we need that last piece. It's looking amazing, though. It's properly good. Okay, give me a call. Bye. Bye.
Yeah, I know.
Every culture has its monsters, its freaks, its deviations from the norm. Perhaps we need them, because without these deviations, how would we define ourselves?
Did you make a wish?
I did. It involved gin and a slice of lemon, but instead...
Maddox says it was a bunch of archaeology students found this.
Weighted down and wrapped in these bags. Not quite the Viking remains they were looking for.
How recent is it?
Not sure yet. But I think we can assume it's all from the same body, adult male.
Any idea how he died?
We've got a... depressed skull fracture with no callus formation and several broken bones.
A beating, then?
Well, not necessarily. Injuries could have been inflicted post-mortem when they threw the body down the well, in which case you're looking for anything that leaves no skeletal evidence.
And you've really no idea how long he's been down the well?
Robbie, I got here 20 minutes before you did. I'm a pathologist, not a clairvoyant.
Sir, spoken to the council. The recycling sacks were issued in May 2012, which means if the body was wrapped in them, it's been here 3 years max.
There you go. Always said pathology was overrated.
Shall I give D.I. Hathaway a call?
Nah, let him have his week off. He'll be doing whatever it is James does.
Reading it up in Magaluf, I imagine.
Sorry I took so long. I got some of these enlarged.
Oh, that's very nice of you. I'm Philip, by the way. Philip Hathaway.
It's me, Dad James.
Oh, yes, of course it is. Oh, dear me. Well, I hope your mother's seen that hair. She hates it short.
Mum died 12 years ago, Dad.
I want him out.
Get him out of here!
Philip! Are you okay?
Could I have your attention, please, ladies and gentlemen? Thank you. My name is Sean Wilkinson, and it gives me great pleasure to introduce to you the artist. Now, let me just say I am extremely excited to be working with such an original talent, Talika Desai.
Thanks, everyone. Well, this is the main piece. It's taxidermy meets video art, and it's called One for Sorrow. Hope you like it.
Curtains, please.
Ollie, selfie time. Smile. Let's have a look. Oh my god. Tao, this is Ollie. He studies law at Hamilton College. Ollie, my sister.
It's good to meet you.
You know Sean.
This is all interesting, different.
Give us your autograph, now you're famous.
You know this is lame, right?
It's for my vlog. You are not putting this online.
I'm going to have to go soon, Dad. But Nell is coming tomorrow, so you won't be, you know.
No, not 98. April 2000, £34, that salmon. Do you remember?
Yes, I do.
You had the whole week off.
No, just a few days. We need to widen the appeal for information. Focus on groups who might use the area. Cyclists, students, joggers, that sort of thing.
Shall I get uniform to follow up that thing at the Ark then?
No, you better do it. The owner won't let uniform through the door.
Is that taxidermy place again?
Yeah, 4th complaint this year. C.S. Moody wants it followed up today.
How is our new leader? I've been summoned to meet him at 10.
Yeah, he's all right. Seems like a decent enough plug.
I hear Innocence leaving Do was eventful.
Oh, I can still see her doing the ABBA karaoke.
I can still hear her. Suffolk Constabulary won't know what's hit it.
For my predecessor. I take it as a vote of confidence. You're the only one she trusts to keep it alive.
She was obviously trying to tell me something, sir.
Don't bother with the sir thing. It's a joke. Look, I realise you're busy. This is just to let you know that you're free to run investigations your way. I remember what it's like. People breathing down your neck.
You were with the Met, were you, Joe?
South London. It was pretty full on. Although Oxford has its own challenges, obviously.
Obviously.
I wanted to ask you, this guy they've dragged back from retirement, Robert Lewis, what do you make of him?
Oh, the loggerhead turtle, now an endangered species, but this one, as you can see, was preserved in the 1930s and is therefore a legally tradable item of vintage taxidermy.
Okay, well, it's just the workshop and then we're done.
Well, that wouldn't be necessary. It's been converted to a private residence now. My assistant lives there.
I'll just pop my head in.
No, I'm sorry, it's too much. You come in here without a warrant. Oh, Sean. Thank goodness.
Everything all right?
No, she's a police officer.
Well, nobody's perfect. Sean Wilkinson, I manage the place. Has my uncle been able to help?
No, she's demanding access to the flat. Spot checks again.
Oh, fair enough.
No, but I knocked earlier. She's asleep.
I'm not surprised the amount she was putting away last night.
But, Sean,
Talika! Talika! She's sorry about this. We need in, babe. Oh, my God. Talika. She's cold.
I'm going to have to ask you to stand back. Talika? Talika Desai, 23, heroin overdose. Hobson thinks she's been dead for 12 hours.
Give or take.
Oh, hello, you're back early. Pining for Robbie?
Always. What do we have?
No obvious signs of trauma. We've got old injection scars on her arms, but they're very faint. She'd been clean for a while.
23 years old.
I know, she was still clutching the needle.
All the old scars are on her right arm, and this new one's on her left.
Yes, I was coming to that.
What's this? This is ink, is it? So it's a writing smudge. If she's left-handed, why didn't she use her dominant arm?
You're saying this could be staged? Someone could have forced the drugs into her?
Well, we can't rule it out, can we?
The owner really didn't want to let me in. And he's on time, hasn't he?
Years ago, for faking import licenses. Not quite the same. She's been in recovery now for 18 months. I just don't understand it.
You were her employers, is that right?
Well, I'd like to think we were more than that. We were, well, maybe not friends precisely, but on friendly terms.
She worked here. I was her agent.
Her agent?
Yeah, for her art stuff. She was my first client.
Only client?
Yeah, so far. Yeah, Jasper taught her a bit of taxidermy and she put her own spin on it. That's one of hers behind you.
Is there a big market for this sort of thing?
You'd be surprised. $3,000 I sold the last one for. Gastropub in Brighton.
Neither of you think of anyone who might want to harm Talika?
No. Why are you asking that?
You think this wasn't an accident? Can we do this outside?
So how long had you known her?
Since last summer, we were advertising for an assistant, but the applicants weren't exactly.
She was the only one without a pierced septum.
Did you see her leave the party?
I wasn't there. I gave a lecture in college, and then I went straight home.
Well, we're going to need a list of everyone who was there, boyfriend, friends.
No, there was no boyfriend. She had a sister, younger sister, in the same college.
Talika was a student here.
Yeah, she'd started a PhD in something.
Experimental psychology at St. Botolph's, but, she dropped out.
Sir, C.S. Moody wants a word.
I'll call him in 5 minutes.
No, he's not on the phone. He's here.
No sign of forced entry. If there was an attacker, they'd probably use the emergency exit. Straight into the alley. No CCTV.
Maddox said you needed to talk about something, sir.
Just checking in. The inventory on this one's going to be interesting.
Usually prefer a pizza myself.
Well, if there is nothing pressing, we really need to talk to the victim's sister, sir.
No, of course, you carry on. Are you liaising with the drug squad?
I will be, thank you, yeah.
I've got a mate there. I'll put a call in for you. Oh, and, make sure you check her finances, too.
Okay. He's aware that we've done this before, isn't he?
Been on the job 3 days. He'll settle in.
Everyone's going to say it was my fault. I was supposed to be keeping an eye on her.
When did she first start using?
After she graduated. She had this PhD lined up and it all got too much.
In what way?
She was one of those kids they put in the newspaper on A-level results day, you know? Then she comes top in psychology, like, out of the whole of Oxford, and her tutor fast-tracks her onto a PhD. I thought she was so perfect.
Who was her tutor?
Vivian Tedman. Will I have to see her?
Not if you don't want to. We already have a formal identification.
Who from?
Some of her colleagues were with the police when she was found.
That guy Jasper.
He was there? Why?
He was always there, just watching her, like, I don't know, just watching.
Are you saying Mr. Hammond had an interest in Talika?
He was leaving her half the shop in his will, so... yeah.
Thanks, Sarah. I'll be in touch.
Stupid girl. Stupid, stupid girl. Sorry, it's just the waste.
Her sister said she qualified top of her year.
She was extraordinary. I know she had this art thing, whatever it was, but Talika was a psychologist, a true scientist.
There you are. Everything okay?
This is D.I. Hathaway. Talika Desai has been found dead.
God. What, drugs?
Did you teach her as well?
No, I don't work here.
How do you know her then?
I don't really. It's just Vivian said that she'd been having some difficulties. Sorry, Ian Tedman. I'm Vivian's husband.
Ian runs a homeless charity. They work with drug counsellors, so I thought he might be able to help with Talika.
What charity is that?
Oh, it's a homeless shelter on Duke Street, you know, with the mobile library van. Should I go on my own? It's just, we did say to the care home we're no later than five. Celebrating 25 years of marriage by having my mother-in-law to stay.
Well done.
She's really not that bad.
She's even better when she's a 3-hour drive away.
Thank you. Okay. What's this?
Forensics found this emerald under Talika's body. It matches exactly this necklace that she's seen wearing in the photos from last night. But wasn't on her body, and Socko couldn't find it, so somebody's taken it.
Yeah, but this isn't about a stolen necklace, is it?
Who knows? But we need another chat with that Sean Wilkinson. Have a look at this. Sahira's an internet vlogger. She uploaded this video from the party last night.
Yes, down it. Come on!
I've got loads ready.
What is the matter with you? Why do this now?
Down it, down it.
Sean conveniently forgot to tell us that he'd had an argument with Talika.
Who is the boy?
Sahira says that it's Professor Tedman's son, Oliver. First date. She says that she was too busy operating the camera. She didn't notice the argument, but, I mean, he obviously clocks it, doesn't he?
Yeah, we should prioritise speaking to Oliver. It'd be good to hear what he heard before we talk to Sean. And Hobson's got toxicology report. We can have a whole 10 minutes if we get there before three.
10 minutes more than we deserve, I'm sure.
Oh, sir. Hathaway. This woman, Nell, called. She says, can you stop screening her calls? And can you get back to her about the fishing rods?
Yeah.
Didn't know you were into fishing.
I'm not.
She died sometime between 10 p.m. and midnight. Her blood alcohol was through the roof. But cause of death, I suspect, it was a massive dose of heroin, forcibly administered.
Forcibly? You sure?
Yes. See how the bruising's small with clear edges? That tells us it was inflicted shortly before death.
What, so someone held her down?
Was she taking drugs in the run-up to this?
The lab tested her hair. All they found over the past 18 months were traces of arsenic.
Arsenic?
Not enough to kill her. Apparently it's been seen before with taxidermists. They used to use arsenic soap as a preservative till the 70s. So if you're repairing old pieces, you can end up ingesting it.
That's another reason I'm not coming tonight. Health and safety.
What's this?
Well, I feel in the interest of thorough police work that we should go and visit her exhibition, but Robert isn't keen.
Yeah, one of us needs to go through Sahira's videos online. But I would be interested to see how much her things are making. You know that thing when an artist dies, sometimes their work doubles in price. What Sean stands to make as her agent.
Is this the exhibition at Eastham Hall? Mm. Well, I'll go with you. I'm going to take that as a yes. You want to talk about your skeleton down the well?
Do we have any usable DNA?
Not yet, but we do have this. Whoever he is, he had an operation on his femur quite a few years before he died.
Well, that hardly narrows it down.
No, but this does. The company that manufactured those pins sold them in a handful of countries in Eastern Europe, so I put my money on him being from Poland or Estonia.
You're good. You're very good. Now?
No, it was Maddox. Jasper Hammond didn't go straight home last night. He lied to us.
And lastly, I got this super cute top. My sister got it in black. I said I didn't want to be in it. Oh, come on, just show us what it looks like on.
Mr. Hammond.
Gentlemen.
I'm always amazed how these finishing touches bring life back. The essence of the creature.
We need to speak to you again about the murder of Talika Desai.
Definitely murder now, is it?
You were seen peering through the window at her exhibition.
I see.
Told us you went straight home after your lecture. But CCTV shows your car parked outside the zoology department all night.
I thought I would be welcome at the exhibition. Talika turned me away. I went to the Admiral, where I had too much to drink. The barman deemed it necessary to call me a minicab.
Why did Talika turn you away?
Well, she was entering the art world. Ethical sourcing was important for her brand, and, given my history, you know.
Your imprisonment for importing endangered species.
It's something I'm deeply ashamed of. Cost me my professorship and my reputation. Now it's just the odd pity lecture when my colleagues deign to throw me a bone.
Can you expand on the exact nature of your relationship with Talika, please?
The nature of our relationship? I was her employer, her landlord.
Friend, would you say?
I said we were on friendly terms.
You were leaving half your business to her in your will. That's a bit more than friendly.
Who told you that? My nephew was still getting half, and with Talika's help, he might have held on to it.
Does he know about this?
No, but it was for his benefit. Sean lost a fortune in property a few years ago. He needed someone sensible to balance him out.
A recovering heroin addict who you'd known for a year.
It was a business decision.
Thank you.
Hello?
Hi.
Hi, DS Maddox. Is Oliver Tedman one of your student volunteers?
Oh, yeah. He's outside somewhere. Ollie? He won't be a minute.
Books for the homeless? That's a good idea.
Yeah, helps us make contact with people. And the city's full of libraries, but homeless people can't always join them.
All right.
The police want to speak to you.
Oh, is this about Sahira's sister? Yeah, she told me what happened.
Yeah, I believe you witnessed an argument between Talika and this man, Sean Wilkinson. Do you know what they said?
No, not really. I mean, they're pretty drunk.
What time did you leave the party?
Just before 9. Yeah, I wasn't feeling very well, so I went home.
Hamilton College?
No, to my parents. I'm sorry, I can't be more help.
Okay.
All right, see you later, Barney.
How did you get those cuts on your face?
It was rugby training this morning. Yeah, scrum collapsed.
Do you often go training after you felt unwell?
When I felt better. I've got a tutorial at 4. Is it okay if I run?
Yeah, sure.
Interesting, just not sure it's right for my living room.
They seem to like it. Aren't they sweet, falling in love over the dead things? Anyway, I wouldn't bring Nell here.
Beg your pardon?
Robbie tells me a young lady called Nell has been enticing you with fishing rods.
Nell is my sister, and the fishing rods were my father's.
Oh. Had us all excited there for a minute.
Were your father's? Oh, God, I'm sorry, James. I had no idea.
No, it's not that. He's in a home. He's got dementia.
Well, that's tough.
Nell says it's for the best.
But you don't think so?
I used to give him all my favourite books when I'd finish with them. Never thought he'd read them. Then when we were packing up his house, I found them. And he'd read them and underlined little bits.
Your turn next. Who's this girl, Sahira?
He's too young for anything serious.
You two weren't much older when...
He's too young! I'm sorry. It's just... that family... it's not appropriate.
So, any progress with identifying the bones in the well?
Well, DNA's gonna be a while, but I've got a different idea.
You know to use the private provider now, not the FSS.
Thank you, I was aware of that.
Help yourselves. And Talika Desai. Drug squad, any help?
No, not even on their radar. No drug debt, no history of dealing. But, you know, I'm not even sure that this is about drugs. There's this missing necklace.
We can't rule out the drug connection, Robert.
No, but a jeweller that Maddox spoke to says this necklace could cost 30 grand. So Talika didn't buy it. Her sister thought it was costume jewellery because it's not a family heirloom.
Forensics?
We've taken DNA from 3 people so far. The victim's sister, Sahira, her agent, Sean Wilkinson, and her employer, Jasper Hammond.
Well, Jasper has to be top of that list, surely.
Well, it's a bit strange. If we arrested every oddball in Oxford, there'd be a teaching crisis.
And his new alibi does stand up. The taxi firm say that they dropped him home.
The fact he went home doesn't mean he stayed home.
All we know for sure is the murderer was aware of her history with drugs.
That doesn't narrow it down, I'm afraid. Thanks to her sister, Talika's problem with heroin is all over the internet. Sahira's most watched video is this one, where she talks about Talika almost overdosing. Some of the comments down below are just vile.
What are you thinking? Troll?
About 90% of the abuse comes from maybe half a dozen of them, especially this one, calling themselves Oscar Wilde. Seriously nasty stuff, directed at both sisters.
One of you two needs to speak to Sahira. Find out if this abuse ever crosses over into real life.
That was to be my next move.
I'm beginning to see your point.
Sorry, I'm late. I went to go and see Oliver Tedman's rugby coach. Ollie was hurt in the scrum, but the coach isn't sure if he arrived with the cuts.
Deliberately getting hurt? Good way to cover up defence wounds.
Apparently he's always getting himself hurt. They actually call him Stitches.
Yeah, but it's not a motive, is it? Do you mind talking to Sahira? We've got an appointment with Sean Wilkinson.
Yeah, no problem. Oh, Lizzie, do you have a copy of Sahira's witness statement?
Oh, it's on Hathaway's desk.
Where are you even getting this from? If my uncle had changed his will, he would have told me.
You must have argued with Talika about something.
Ah, no, it wasn't an argument. She was drunk. I persuaded her to go home.
Can you take us through what you were doing between the hours of 10 p.m. and midnight?
I was at the party till 1 a.m. when the porters shut us down. Ask any of the 30-odd guests. Now, I'm sorry, I did say I'd get this to London by 11, so if that's everything.
Yeah, we wouldn't want to keep you.
Great. Actually, you make a start on your own. See you down there.
I can talk to the guests, but it won't tell us much. It's like a wedding, isn't it?
Not an experience I'm familiar with, I'm afraid.
Well, when you're hosting lots of people, people assume that when you're not talking to them, you must be mingling with somebody else. The flat's so close, you'd have only needed 10 minutes. Me and Tony managed to sneak off her up. Sir?
The bank got back to us. Talika was receiving money every month, a lot of money every month, from her old tutor's husband, Ian Tedman. £27 payments over the last 3 years, all for £500, all from Ian Tedman.
Right.
And then in March, the payments stopped. Talika requested that the bank block any future ones. Do you think that is an affair?
Could be.
You all right?
Is there a problem with my work?
No, of course not.
But you knew about this?
Moody wanted to eliminate your position. I wrote that in your defence.
I don't need you to fight my corner, James. If my face doesn't fit...
No, I simply wrote the truth. This department needs you and your face is never fitted. It's part of your charm.
Ah, Moody does fire me. You'll have to be the one to tell him about our skeleton in the well. The right femur contained 4 pins, which are only manufactured by 1 company. This company only supplies 3 hospitals, 1 in Poland, 2 in Estonia. About 1,000 people have had surgery using the pins, but only 32 of them have needed 4. Now, of those 32, only 1 man's x-ray matched our femur. Indrek Kolder. Originally from Estonia, but on our system is using Class A drugs and sleeping rough in Oxford. He did 6 months for possession in 2007.
Nice work.
That's what I'm paid for.
Sean! wrong?
You know exactly what's wrong!
Yes, Indrek. He used to be one of our regulars. He was a really sweet guy. Come on, darling. Mummy needs to go inside. He used to do odd jobs, actually. He was a carpenter till things got on top of him.
When did Indrek last use the shelter?
He slept here on and off for a couple of years. Last time would have been summer 2012, I think. I can check the records for you. Do you want to sit down, sweetheart?
Were there ever any problems involving him?
Nothing specific. He had his issues with drugs, but he made these shelves, actually. Is he in trouble?
I'm afraid I'm investigating Indrek's murder.
He's dead. Sorry, I didn't even know him that well. It's just there, but for the grace of God. I was homeless myself for 3 months. This place helped me.
Well, you're obviously doing a great job. I might have some time on my hands soon.
Afternoon, this is Sergeant Maddox. We have a few more questions.
Okay, sure. Viv!
No, actually, it was you we wanted to speak to. Probably best in private.
I'm sure there's no need.
Okay.
These are Talika Desai's bank statements from the last 3 years. The highlighted payments came from your account.
I think it's fairly obvious what that's about.
I had only met her once. I sat next to her at a college fundraiser. Then a few months later, we bumped into each other at a bar and it went from there. I'm not proud of it.
What was the arrangement exactly?
It wasn't an arrangement.
It was, Ian. It was what they call a sugar daddy arrangement. He told me all about it a few months ago when he came to his senses. Or rather, when she did. She got bored. But 25 years of marriage is a lot to throw away.
We're making a fresh start, aren't we? Hence the anniversary party.
Did you give Talika any jewellery?
No, just the money. Why?
Where were you between 10 p.m. and midnight on Tuesday?
We were here. Yeah. Our son came around about 10. He wasn't feeling very well, was he? So all three of us were in bed by 11.
We'd appreciate it if this relationship didn't get back to Ollie. It would devastate him.
He's involved with Talika's sister, is that correct?
That won't come to anything. But all the more reason not to broadcast this.
We don't make those sort of promises, I'm afraid.
Why do these trolls write this stuff about you and Talika? Some of these are disgusting.
All the big vloggers get it. It shows people are watching.
Whoever wrote this comment, this Oscar Wilde, have they ever tried to contact you in the real world?
No, it's all online.
There's something else I need to ask you. Did your sister ever mention a relationship with an older man?
No.
She never mentioned Ian Tedman, her tutor's husband.
Ollie's dad. Are you serious?
Ollie, mate. I need you to listen to me, okay?
I know you're in there. You knew, didn't you? About your dad and my sister. You're sick!
And for all this, nature is never spent. There lives the dearest freshness deep down things. And though the last lights of the Black West went, oh, morning at the brown brink eastwards, springs.
Look at this one. I mean, what's the point?
Performance art not your thing, then?
I don't think it's anyone's thing, is it? There's hours of this stuff at Talika's flat. Don't feel you have to stay.
I don't mind. Tell you what, why don't I get us a couple more coffees?
I'm not sure if I'll post this or not, but I need someone to talk to. I think I know what happened to my sister.
This one's a bit dark.
What's it meant to be?
Oh, no. Yeah, that's him. That's Indrek Calder. Our body in the well.
Well, why is this?
I don't know, but it's not art. I think we've just watched Indrek Calder's murder.
I've seen some of this footage before. She used it in her exhibition, just a few seconds of it.
Talika knew who killed Indrek.
Find that room.
His name's Jasper Hammond. I think he found out that she was seeing someone else and he flipped.
You knew he was ill, James, but it's easier to pretend nothing's wrong, isn't it?
And the drama continues with a new series of Lewis next Tuesday from 9. An undiscovered crime puts four very different suspects in the frame on Thursday at 9. Another new drama series starts here on ITV, Unforgotten. And if you're in the mood for more drama right now, a mysterious phone message alerts DCI Banks to a family crisis. It's about to start on ITV Encore. Or stay with us next for the ITV News at 10.